Yeah. and for the choice of which I was not responsible, made me inordinately miserable. I tried to leave it. I wanted to go to Aquila, the opposite of Roman. Every respect, and actually found it in a spirit of enmity towards that city, just as I also shall found a city someday, as a memento of an atheist and genuine enemy of the church, a person very closely related to me, the great Hohenstaufen, the Emperor Frederick II. But fate lay behind it all. I had to return again to Rome. In the end, I was obliged to be satisfied with the Piazza Barberini, after I had exerted myself in vain to find an anti-Christian quarter. I fear that on one occasion, to avoid bad smells as much as possible, I actually inquired of the Palazzo del Quirinale whether they could not provide a quiet room for a philosopher. In a chamber high above the piazza just mentioned, from which one obtained a general view of Rome that he hear the fountain splashing far below, the low music of all songs was composed a night song. About this time I was obsessed by an unspeakable sad melody, the refrain of which I recognized in the words, "Yet here I am." Mortality. You remained somewhat too long in Rome this spring, and look at the effect of the increasing heat and the discouraging circumstances already described. My brother resolved not to write anymore, or in any case, not to proceed within cloth, Zarathustra, and cloth, although I offered to relieve him of all trouble in connection with the proofs and the publisher. When, however, he returned to Switzerland towards the end of June, and he found himself once more in the familiar and exhilarating months. Air of the mountains, all his girl's creative powers revived, and in a note to me announcing the dispatch of the manuscript, he wrote as follows, and thought, I have engaged a plate pie for three. Pursued, I am the greatest soul to allow my courage to. Introduction, 19. The involuntariness of the figures and similes is the most remarkable thing. One loses all perception of what constitutes the figure and what constitutes the simile. Everything seems to present itself as the readiest, the correctest, and the simplest means of expression. It actually seems, to use one of Zarathustra's own phrases, as if all things came unto one, and would fain be similes. Here do all things come caressingly to thy talk and flatter thee, for they want to ride upon thy back. On every simile dost thou here ride to every truth. Here fly open unto thee all being as words and word cabinets. Here all being wanteth to become words. Here all becoming wanteth to learn of thee how to talk. This is my experience of inspiration. I do not doubt but that one would have to go back thousands of years in order to find someone who could say to me, it is mine also. And quoi? In the autumn of 1883 my brother left the Engadine for Introduction. 21. Germany and stayed there a few weeks. In the following winter, after wandering somewhat erratically through Stresa, Genoa, and Spezia, he landed in Nice, where the climate so happily promoted his creative powers that he wrote the third part of Quod Zarathustra, and Quod, in the winter, beneath the halcyon sky of night, which then looked down upon me for the first time in my life. I found the third Zarathustra and came to the end of my task, the whole having occupied me scarcely a year. Many hidden corners and heights in the landscapes round about Nice are hallowed to me by unforgettable moments. That decisive chapter entitled Old and New Tables was composed in the very difficult ascent from the station to Isa, that one dirkle Moorish village in the rocks. My most creative moments were always accompanied by unusual muscular activity. The body is inspired. Let us wait the question of the soul. I might often have been seen dancing in those days. Without a suggestion of fatigue, I would then walk for 7 or 8 hours on end among the hills. I slept well and laughed well. I was perfectly robust and patient. And quod, as we have seen, each of the three parts of and quod, Zarathustra and quod, was written, after a more or less short period of preparation, in about 10 days. The composition of the fourth part alone was broken by occasional interruptions. The first notes relating to this part were written while he and I were staying together in Zurich in September 1884. In the following November, while staying at Mentone, he began to elaborate these notes, and after of his ideal of the majestic philosopher. His reasons, however, for choosing Zarathustra of all others to be his mouthpiece, he gives us in the following words: "And God, people have never asked me, as they should have done, what the name Zarathustra precisely means in my mouth, in the mouth of the first immoralist. For what distinguishes that philosopher from all others in the past is the very fact that he was exactly the reverse of an immoralist. Zarathustra was the first to see in the struggle. It seemed good and evil the essential rule in the working of things. The translation of morality into the metaphysical is full of cause, and in itself, with this work. Did the very question suggest its own answer? Zarathustra to man, and much within you is still worm. Once were ye apes, and even yet man is more of an ape than any of the apes. Even the wisest among you is only a disharmony and hybrid of plant and phantom. So do I bid you become phantoms or plants? Lo, I reach you the Superman. The Superman is the meaning of the earth. Let your will say, the Superman shall be the meaning of the earth. I conjure you, my brethren, remain true to the earth, and be. DARATHUSTRASTROLLD in UM. Closing parenthesis. Leave not those who speak unto your super earthly hopes. The poisoners are they, whether they know it or not. Despisers of life are they, decaying ones and poisoned ones themselves, of whom the earth is weary, so away with them. Once blasphemy against God was the greatest blasphemy, but God died, and there was also those blasphemers. To blaspheme the earth is now the dreadfulest sin, and to rate the heart of the unknowable higher than the meaning of the earth. Once the soil looked contemptuously on the body, and then that contempt was the supreme thing. The soul wished the body meager, ghastly, and famished. Thus it ought to escape from the body and the earth. Oh, that soul was itself meager, ghastly, and famished, and cruelty was the delight of that soul. But he, also, my brethren, tell me, what does your body say about your soul? Is your soul not poverty, arid pollution, and rest itself complacency, verily, a polluted stream of man? One must be a sea, to receive a polluted stream without becoming a sinner. So, I teach you the Superman. He is that sea. In him can your great contempt be submerged. What is the greatest thing ye can experience? It is the hour of great contempt. The hour in which even your happiness becometh loathsome. to hear with their eyes. Must one platter like kettle mount their antennae? I are the stress, prologue, H. Potential creatures, or do they only look into the mirror? They have something rare if they are proud. What do they call it? That which makes them proud. Culture, they call it, ill-distinguished. The promoter, they dislike, therefore, the mirror has tempted themselves, so I will
To teach men the sense of their existence.